My name is Marcel Labelle, and I'm a health and safety inspector for the Ontario Ministry of Labour. Today we're at the Ragged Rapids Ontario Power Generation Dam. There's a diving project being conducted here for care and maintenance, in which stop logs will be checked for seals and removal with a 60-ton crane and with a full diving team in place. Diving operations at power dams have serious hazards of differential pressures. Delta P, we call it. A diver could be sucked into an opening. There is piping, trash trays and everything else, and overflow piping. There's many hazards in dealing with power generating dams. Once a diver is injured in a dam environment, it is often fatal.
We'll test the lights and the camera.
Today I'm going to be showing you exactly what an inspector is looking for as far as the safety requirements and hazards during a diving operation at a power dam. When I arrive on site, I'm always looking for the diving supervisor. Afterwards, several documentation will be looked at. The operational plan will be looked at, to detailing what the scope of the work is going to be, what procedures are going to be in place, lockout procedures, differential pressure testing protocols and procedures are going to be to ensure that there is no seepage or leakage within the dam structure itself.
What's the scope of the work that's being conducted here today?
Essentially what we're doing is removing the sealing material from the stop logs, removing the stop logs, and then we're going to be installing trash racks. Everything's identified in our job safety analysis. We discuss lockouts, we discuss Delta P, we discuss Delta P planning, Delta P rescue.
The workers are all checked out as far as their competency and credentials as well, and their medicals, all based on the CSA standards as far as competency levels and training. Their logs are looked at.
Shea has been active diving in the past couple weeks, so he should have some updated logs.
The contingency plan details if there's a dam above, dam below, who the contacts are. They're going to close off the dams to minimize water flow and pressures and build up, as well as the contact numbers and the liaison to the emergency facilities that are going to be required for assistance as well.
I just switched your air onto the compressor.
This is the oxygen system that we have on site.
That's a double tank system.
That's a double tank system. Okay. If we run it at 25 liters per minute, we have approximately 50 minutes of oxygen on board. Ideally, though, we'd use the demand regulator.
Volumes of oxygen is important. It has to be calculated to ensure that there's enough in case of an emergency to either get to the emergency facilities or emergency facilities get to
so
site.
So what I would like to concentrate on is knowing what our Delta P exposure is going to be, that as we start pulling stop logs from the far side, we're going to start exposing ourselves to Delta P. So let's work safe, start far, and then always keep double protection in any event.
If a diver is aware that there are safety issues on that dive site, he has a right to refuse work until the corrective measures are taken. And that is a requirement under the Occupational Safety Act, that all workers have a right to refuse unsafe work.
Let's concentrate on limiting the diver's movement to protected bays.
Workers have a duty to ensure that they know what their working environment is going to be, that all the safety measures and procedures are in place.
Lock number 8 should be head gate 2 supply. Lock number 9, it's a second head gate 1 supply breaker.
That's correct.
Tag number 51 for permatree.
Lock number 10051.
They need to be instructed and informed on the operational plan as well as the contingency plan prior to starting any work within that diving operation. Owners, constructors, employers, and supervisors all have a responsibility in ensuring that the safety factors are in place. For more information, please visit our website.